Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I just thought I'd start this part of my food prep program here. Is dehydrating foods. This stuff I've had in my freezer. And for those people that are from Alaska, particularly Fairbanks area, this ham like what I got here, it's kind of like what you can buy at the grocery store, only the little ones. But this comes in great big cubes. They're like 20 pounds. And I get that from, what's the name of the place? I'll think of it and I'll get back with you on that. But anyway, all I'm doing right now is I'm just cutting this up and I'm getting ready for the dehydrator. Now, this is already cooked ham. So, this works good for salads or I like to put it in macaroni and cheese or omelets. About anything you can think of. Not really any good for sandwiches because it's not that kind of a consistency. Quality Sales is where I get this from in Fairbanks. That's a restaurant supply place. And you heard me talk about Azure. And while I get a lot of stuff from them, and I'm going to get stuff from them in the future, Quality Sales is a little more expensive than Azure, but you don't pay any freight, or your freight's already figured into your cost. But I'm finding that a lot of this stuff you can get in larger quantities. So if you want to can it and you don't have enough, for example, like tomatoes, I think Azure has got them in a couple 5-pound quantities, and Quality Sales has got them like by 50-pound boxes. And I don't know how much they are, and they changed their format. It used to be you just printed it out and fast remailed it in your order, and it was a written thing. And now since COVID has hit, the only way they do things is you have to call it in. So it's just a different way of doing things. But they're on Phillips Field Road, right behind Spinards. And they're right next door to Samson's Hardware. And for those of you that are in the lower 48, or maybe that are new to Alaska, Samson's is kind of our go-to hardware store for the old-time stuff. Be kind of like what the old Cumberland store used to be, or Lehman's, just in Alaska. Word of warning, they are not cheap. As nothing is here in Alaska. So I'll do this and then I'll stop it and I'll bring you back when I get to the next step. I just got done dehydrating a bunch of shredded cheddar cheese and then I powdered it. And I kind of like how it turned out. Y'all can chime in and comment on things you see that you think I'm doing wrong or a better way. Because I'm not a professional cook like I'm sure a lot of you are. Now, I'm going to swing you around here. I didn't think when I bought this, I didn't think I would use it as much as I do. However, since I've had it, it hasn't shut off. Other than when I'm loading it. And I haven't had it that long, so we're gonna wait and see what my power bill is. 600 watts. See what my power bill is. But I'm thinking if I can eliminate a deep freeze, it'll pay for itself. And then the other thing, by doing it this way, is that in the summertime, should we ever lose power for an extended period of time, or if I've got a freezer that quits, it's not a big deal because everything's dehydrated. Kind of brings me to another note, not on this subject, but you'll notice, well, you won't until you get here, but things in, I don't know why it is, but things in Alaska, it just seems to be that it's hard on, Alaska's hard on things. And, so you want to have extras. And I'll give you an example. Oh, here about 3 weeks ago, my well froze up. My own fault, because I unplugged the heat tape, but it was the 1st of May. And I should have known better, but I wanted to save money. And lo and behold, about 3 days later, my well froze up. And I'll show you one day, but I have a 1,000-gallon water tank in my basement. And I have a pressure pump. Like when I was a kid, we had a cistern. So that 1,000-gallon tank is like my sister. Because growing up, we always had to hold water 1,000 gallons at a time. So, anyway, the water froze up, and I thought, hey, no big deal. I'll just go to the basement, plug my heat tape in, switch over my pumps, and I'm good to go. So I did that, and I plugged my heat tape in. Lo and behold, my heat tape wasn't working. And that's 135-foot heat tape down deep. It's about, my water line's about 14-foot deep. And, but anyway, so I did discover that right away, but then I changed over to my pump. Well, my pressure pump had quit working. So even though I had a backup system, yet the backup system failed. So then I got to investigating, and I found where the ground had broken off on the heat tape, so I had to redo that, and I had the heat tape back. But and in the meantime, I got another pressure pump, and got that in. Then when I got that in, the check valve that I had from the water tank to the pressurized system broke. They get corroded and they stick open. So when the pump would quit running, the pressure would run back into the tank. So, there for a couple days, you can see the redundancy that it was. Now, some of it I was prepared for, because I did have more check valves. I keep those down there. Got the pressure pump going, got the heat tape going. And so then about a day later, maybe not even that long, I had water from the well again. But kind of the point I'm telling y'all is, when I have to go for parts, for me, It's about a 260-mile round trip to get parts. So you figure it's a whole day. And at the price of gas, just so you know, it cost me a $100 bill, basically, to go round trip. And so that's why you like to have extra on stock. And a lot of it, too, is because where we live, you can't be guaranteed when you go for something that they're going to have it, because especially nowadays. And so it just means that you got to either adapt or if you have extra. The reason I say on stuff like this, by having extra, instead of having to modify pipes and everything, it's just a simple matter of unscrewing one and putting the next one in. And so that's what's nice about that. Okay. Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen. That's a load of ham. And so now what we'll do is I'll bring you over here and show you. Because what I'll do is, I don't keep that plugged in, but I just took the cheddar cheese out. So now, what I'll do is I'll set the temp. So all you gotta do is, right there, it's 95, hit the plus. And I'm gonna go up to 130, because I don't really want to cook it, I just want to dry it out. And we want to go 24 hours. And you hit the start over here. And we're good to go, ladies and gentlemen. So with that, I'm going to shut the video down and then we'll pick up later on another subject, or maybe we'll continue on this. So hope y'all have a good day. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's 24 hours later from when I loaded the dehydrator. So I checked it last night before I went to bed, and everything was pretty well good to go then. So I just left it in overnight. But as you can see, there's the dehydrated ham. Okay. So I got a little kitchen scraper here. I just kind of use that to just make sure everything is broke loose. And then I've got my canning funnel there in my jar, and all I do just like that. These kind of nylon mats, if you got a dehydrator, I really recommend those, because I need to get one more set, but as you'll see here, it really makes life easy. So I just fold it up like so and bring up the back end, kind of like a diaper, I guess. Just like that. And if you're kind of wondering, this is my I've got to have a series here on my food prep in storage, because never was what you call a prepper. Kind of laughed at them, but lately it has been difficult to get things in Fairbanks. And those of you that have full grocery shelves, that's wonderful, but we don't. Okay. So, case you're wondering why I'm not handling this thing barehanded, it's hot! What I'm starting to do is I'm kind of starting to cook with this, because by cooking with it, I learn how to do it. So if I ever have to use it in an emergency, there, you can see how much that settled. And what that will do, we got the whole thing in there. Now, let's just see what we can do here. Okay, so we'll go to the next one. Probably going to have to get another quart jar out here. Thought I had two of them in there, but I put one of them in a pint. Leave us a little room. I try and get these things jarred up relatively quickly so they don't absorb any moisture. Now, doing this in the winter time, seeing how I heat with wood, I don't think moisture is a problem, because my humidity in the house, I struggle to get it above 10%. And yes, the static electricity is a shocker. Alrighty. I'm going to shut her down for now, ladies and gentlemen, and I'll bring you back. I need to clean a few more jars and get those all sanitized, and then I'll bring you back. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. We got us a sanitized jar, quart jar, so we can continue. In case you're wondering, what I do is I wash these jars out good, because they're new jars. And then, rather than drying them, I put them in a 250 degree oven and let them dry in there. Okay. So, And I'll top off the ham that was left over from yesterday when we get this all done. Okay. Oops. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to transfer. There. Okay, and just me, I like to do my lids all facing in the same direction. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I'll be back in a minute. I'm going to take you into the vacuum sealer, and we're going to vacuum seal these guys. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're back at the vacuum sealer now. So what we're going to do, this is my VacMaster VP230. Now, before I turn it on, I need to leave the release it so the hood comes up. And then I'll turn it on. When you see these two lines here, that's telling me that it's ready to go. Now, I have got the sealer turned off, and that's turned off by going to the set, and that tells you vacuum, and that tells you how many seconds it's going to vacuum. And okay, and then that's sealing. You notice I got zero, so it's no sealing time, it's not going to seal. And then the cooling is 3 seconds, and we go back and we're ready to go. So now, the only thing we got to do is put our jars in. Okay, these are quart jars. You leave your lid loose, and you put them, you lay them down. Just like so. And the only thing you have to do at this point is close the lid. And that's it. The ED down here, that tells you that it's ready for the next cycle. You can check your lids right like that. And that tells you they're sealed. Okay, so then when I'm done, you just turn it off. And you're good to go. So, that's it for this, ladies and gentlemen. I'll bring you back at a later time. Thank you for watching.